Wait, what the? We're good. Yo, Big Mike, what up? What up? Oh, fuck my cheek, dude. I got some things to tell you. Yeah, I know. You better tell me, cause some shit's happening. I know something's happening. What the hell's going on, man? Okay. Let me use the restroom really quick, really quick. Best dream. I ain't gonna lie, I almost came out the bathroom without washing my hands. But come on, let's be honest. When you're home and you're not taking a dookie, you gonna really wash your hands? Come on, let's be honest. But I wash my hands, so ain't no one can give me shit about that. Wait, what's happening? What's happening? I don't know. You tell me. We could talk about that later. I don't know. But something's happening. I know something's happening. I'm gonna fix my pants. Alright. Guys, we're at day... fuck. We're at day something today. Day. I'll tell you right now what day we're on. Day 56. So I make sure I wash my hands. Oh yeah, no. You know, when you come home, of course, you know, people wash their hands. That's cool. I mean, I wash my hands too. I sanitize and I wash my hands right before I get home. But besides that, did you have a dinner? Dude, speaking about dinner today, let me get this in first. Let me get the first workout in, and then I got some disappointing news to tell you about today's diet. We got these bands, and today I was like Googling really quick. Well, I didn't Google, I saw a video about these twins that have the perfect butts. And they work out their legs all day, every day. And they got the best shaped booty in the world. Or something like that. And I saw them do these squats. And I was like, damn, that would really change up the game. So instead of doing regular squats, what am I doing wrong here? Instead of doing regular squats, they add a little twist to it. Considering squats are our first workout today, disappointing? Oh no, yeah, it's pretty disappointing. I'm really disappointed in myself. Okay, what if we loop this around? Twice. Maybe one more time. I think this is better. Sausage. Deer sausage? Okay. Here we go. I don't know if I'm gonna do this right, but this is what I saw. Instead of doing regular squats, we do a regular squat like this. And then we move down. Oh, you know what? I'm gonna change the game right now. Look at this last week like this. What? Now we're killing it. Look how much more of a workout we're getting. All right. Regular squats. Down. Ridiculous, right? 20, holy shit. No, not tonight, tomorrow. I'm making deer chili tomorrow. Oh shit, alright. Deer dick, deer sausage. That's what I think of every time you say deer sausage. But deer's pretty cool. I had deer once. I don't know if it was really deer. But if it's called veal, I've had veal before. It's pretty good. It's definitely a different taste. Holy shit, that's a workout. I shake my head. Yeah. Man. Yeah, but today I fucked up real hard. Isn't veal a bird? I thought veal was deer. I fucked up then. Hold up. Veal. Well, is that even how you spell veal? I thought it was V-E-I-L. Maybe I'm wrong too. Oh, it is veal. You're right, you're good. Veal is the meat of calves. In contrast to the beef from older cattle, veal can be produced from a calf of either sex and breed. However, most veal comes from young males of dairy breeds who are not used for breeding. Generally, veal is more expensive than beef from older cattle. Okay. So technically, veal can be deer, right? Or does it have to be a calf? Okay. Can a deer be veal? Venison is deer meat. Okay, I've had venison. It typically has a flavor similar to beef, but it is stronger. Listen, this is a question. This is not even a legit answer. This is someone's opinion and their goddamn grammar sometimes. While I have not had any that tastes wild or gamey, I have heard that some cuts do taste that way. Veal is calf, very young cow. Okay. Veal is, hey Wonder Woman, how you doing? How are you doing? You okay? It's nice to see you. Welcome back. Hope everything's okay. Hope you're doing good. Hope everyone's doing good. Big Mike, I hope you're doing good. Hope everyone's doing good. Shit, we're good. We're good. Everyone's doing good. Hope so. I'm doing good. Well, I'm not doing good, but I'm doing alright. Okay. Alright, let's do this ridiculous set 2. I still gotta tell you guys how I fucked up my diet today so bad. Okay. One. I'm not flustered, man. Don't say that. I'm not flustered, come on. I'm out of breath because of working out. That's all, doing these stupid bands and stuff. Feels new to me, so I'm gonna feel a little bit exhausted. More than I should. It's totally not why she's here. But listen, she's a bro. Just like you, Big Mike, alright? Okay, but anyways, I went to that buffet yesterday, right? And we snuck in some oyster crackers, soup crackers, whatever you want to call it. Took them to work. First thing in the morning, was on my desk, chowed down, one bag, about like 70 calories. You know, I was like, let me live a little bit today. You know, I had my salad and my hard-boiled egg for lunch. And I guess those crackers activated my stomach because I was so hungry way before I usually get hungry for lunch. Ate lunch an hour earlier than I usually do. Then somebody said, oh, they're ordering pizza. I was like, oh, pizza. Had to put an order of a slice in. Ate a slice. And my salad. Skipped the hard-boiled egg though. But that's another mistake I did because my coworker couldn't finish her pasta. Her pasta a la vodka. She's like, oh, you want to taste some? I'm like, fine. Tasted that shit. It was so good. Ate like a good 10, 20. Maybe not 20, but maybe like 10 pieces of pasta. Fucked up real big. You know, it wasn't like, I don't know what got into me. I think I was really, really, really worried about something. Worried about some people, you know, just stressing out a bit. And what I do to deal with stress sometimes, which is not healthy, I tend to eat. So I think I overate today. Came home, that egg I had, I didn't eat for lunch. I had it in my pocket and I was like, shit, came home. I had some salad still sitting in my house. Put the salad in a empty jar of mayo. You know, with this mayo like literally surrounding just on the sides of the little mayo container. Chopped up the eggs, put it in there, shook it up. Finished that whole thing. And it's not so bad if you just have salad and an egg, but there was a lot more mayo than I actually estimated. And chugged down a shitload of mayo with my salad. I don't think it's me. All right. Good, it's not you. I'm cutting out carbs. Oh, nice, nice. Cutting out carbs. You are an inspiration. Like many people out there, you're not that special, all right? You're just a person here. Nobody cares you're cutting out carbs, all right? Yeah, but good shit though, good shit. Cutting out carbs is so hard to do. I don't know how people do it. I don't know how you do it. Why do you have an egg in your pocket? Because I couldn't finish the egg. I'm not gonna just throw the egg out. It's a hard-boiled egg. It's still good for like another half a day or something, right? I took it home, put it in my pocket, took it home. Nothing wrong with that. Because you're the crazy ones, guys, alright? I'm sure anybody would have took that home as well. What are you gonna do? You gonna hold the egg all day? I'm gonna put it in my pocket. Shit. What you love in life, I'm cutting it out. Oh, man. Damn. I wish I was carbs right now. Why is it that it was in your pocket though? Because I'm just taking it home. How weird do I look doing this all day? Going home like this. I'm gonna put this in my pocket. Low carb, high fat. Yeah, that's what I wanna do. Low carbs, high fat. Her fats are really good for you, so. You don't have a container? You look more ridiculous having a container for your egg, alright? You guys are really judging me about holding an egg. Let me show you what you would look like if you had a container for your egg. Okay. Look how ridiculous this looks. I'm not gonna do this all day. Alright? Shit. You don't have a purse like I do, so what's that? You know, my pet, damn it, Mike. You're a cute guy, that's what I try to do. That's what I do. I try. I heard the keto diet. The keto diet's pretty good. My friend's on the keto diet. He lost like 60 pounds in like 3 months. This man walks off screen on one side, comes back on the other side. Hey, man, continuity, baby, you know. This is a great workout, guys. Adding these in there, really making it intense. I'm starting to think that's why my legs were in such incredible pain last time I did my leg workout. It's because of these damn bands, which is great. But yeah, I was a. It was a really weird past couple days. Monday was really weird. Not weird, but like just, I don't know, something about Monday was weird. I don't know. Tell me to get up. Tell me to get up and get another water bottle. I needed 10 cups today. Damn it, I was hoping you guys didn't bring a water today. Get the fuck off your chair right now. Get that water. Right now. Please. Let's do it. Let's all get some water. The hell, there's no. I don't get the thank you though. This is for Ange. I mean, hot gamer woman. Remember, he ought to be polite to Canadian. The thank you is for you. Thank you for you is a given nerd. All right. I guess Canadians feel a little brave today. It's all good. Let you rock today. Today's your day. Welcome back to Wonder Woman. Ting. I drank a shitload of water today. I worked all day, I was just drinking water. So I was like, you know what, maybe I should not drink it during the workout today. I got some real disappointing news. I will not be able to hit 10 pounds lost on day 60 coming up. I think it's in 5 days or less. I'm sorry to disappoint. Made a mistake by going to the buffet yesterday. Made a mistake ordering that slice today. I made a mistake really eating those pieces of pasta I shouldn't have. I want to apologize to everyone that's been out there supporting me. I feel like I've let you guys down, but I promise you, if you give me an extra 5 days, day 65, I think I can hit it. I was only 1 pound away from 20 pounds lost, man. 1 pound away, I fucked it up. You know, I hit these like, little setbacks, but you know what they say about a setback? A setback is just a setup for a comeback. So, who are you hitting? Oh, I mean like I want to hit 20 pounds lost. Figuratively, I want to hit 20 pounds lost. It ain't final till you see those numbers, you still got time. Well, ...4.8 pounds from hitting our 20 pounds lost. Emotionally healed. Shit.
Me too, man. Me too. I fucking gained weight. I was eating like crazy. I can't lie.
Oh, such a weird couple days. But you know what? Like I said, we're gonna come back from this. Like Big Mike said, it ain't final. We still got time. Today, I really got out of control. I hope everyone is doing okay today. I just want to say. I'm so mad because I found pictures of me from like end of high school to start of college and damn, I was cute and thin. You think you're not cute and thin now? Alright. I mean, we should work out actually. What's the next workout? What's next? Really quick, leg workout. Okay, what's next on the list? Squats, lunges. God damn it, lunges. I fucking hate lunges. What you mean, Wallace? You still are? Yes, you still are. Come on, girl. Come on. You gotta appreciate yourself, okay? Especially a woman. You need to appreciate yourself. You don't need anyone to tell you look good, because you know what? You look good. Just believe in yourself. You know, it doesn't mean you should, like, not work on yourself. You should continue to work on yourself, because that's going to make you feel better too. See, a lot of benefits. I'm just saying. I was 00 on pant size, and now I'm at 8. Well, listen. See, I sell women pants on the weekend. A 00 is, like, unhealthily. It's very unhealthy to be a 00, in my opinion. I think a good average size, like a good foundation, is like a size 8, honestly. So what I would do is say, anyone that's a 00, congratulations, but you should eat some more or something. So, do you even know what it looked like? Laugh my ass off. The smallest pant size one could get. 00 is the smallest size, yeah. For someone my height though, every woman should know they look good. Yes. Facts. To this day, I have not sold a pants. I have not sold a 00 in my life. Okay, the smallest size I ever sold was like a 0, and then I have occasionally a 1 or a 2 there, but 1 or 2 are like kid sizes, you know, like infant sizes. Like, as soon as you come out the womb, okay, you're a 00, you're a 0, okay? As soon as you turn 1, you're already a size 3, okay? Stop thinking like you have to maintain a 00 or like, you know, keep up with other people that are unhealthy and extremely small, right? I think the most beautiful women are the women that are like size 8 and up, you know? Of course, it depends on your height and your body figure and the ratio and everything, but I think a good starting point is a size 8. You know, like, no man should wear a size, how do I compare this with a man? Doesn't matter, it's not the point, alright? The point is, stop trying to, like, hit these impossible, crazy, dangerous sizes, alright? Women just need to appreciate themselves. Every woman's beautiful, alright? And that's it. No more of that. No more of that nonsense talk. I don't want to hear that shit. Okay, lunges. I'm satisfied, reach 2. Go get some water, drink another cup. I don't want to hear that. See, if you're size 2, man, you know, I don't want to talk about it. I'm not here to judge people, okay? I'm the last person that's going to be judging somebody about pant sizes. On top of that, I freaking sell women's pants, like, on the weekend. Oh, hold up. Is Canadian size 2 different than US size 2? Maybe that's a thing. Let me see something really quick. Canada, woman size 2 pants versus USA. They're probably gonna say, oh, wait. Oh no, international US, Canada. Hold up. Fuck, it might be different. Damn it, imagine Canada sizes are even smaller. Then I'm gonna really lose it. US. Oh, I think it's the same. No, because you know why I think it's the same? Because women, pant sizes, they go by numbers, right? Well, in Europe, it's by numbers, right? 0, 00, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, up to like 40, 44, 45. That's the international sizing, actually, now that I think about it. So, I'm pretty sure that actually works for US and Canada. Yeah, that's what I recall. I think that's true. Okay, lunges. We switch. 15. And we're not gonna sit today. We're gonna stand all day today. If you say so. Yeah, no, because I have Canada customers. Canadian customers. I have people come down from Canada to my store. I mean, they don't come every day, but they come like every summer and stuff to come visit. And they buy bulk, you know? It's not every time they can shop at my store, you know, and get graced with my presence. So, yeah, Canada got some great people. I'd say my best customers are Canadian. My best customers are actually not even from New York. They're from Baltimore, Canada. We got a few from like Cali. And then there's a very few amount of people locally, like in the boroughs, like Brooklyn, the Bronx, that come by. So, do you show them the candies? No. First of all, you guys already know I was like a lot bigger. Well, I'm pretty big still, but like, I was like, you know, just like 2 months ago. I mean, I'm still pretty big. I mean, I could see myself and I'm pretty damn big, but no. It's hard, you know, it's really difficult to like sell pants to a woman as a male. Unless you're like really, really like, you know, like feminine to them, if you know what I mean. So I hit them up with the tough love, like, so when a woman doesn't know her size, like I just say, okay, lift up your shirt. Not okay. Women typically have like a long jacket, right? That covers up the waist. So I go lift it up. So they do one of these. They go into these, and I'm like, bam, got you. I already know your size. All right, just tell me what you like, what color you like, what size, I mean, what style you like. I'll get you the size, no problem. But then, lift up your shirt. Not the shirt, like lift up whatever you have on top, all right? And then there's like a, you know, a very good percentage of women that really debate me, like legs, ankles, calves, thighs, really toned down. And then, you know, sometimes, you know, the stomach is a really big issue for, you know, the waist is a big issue for most women and males, don't get me wrong. But, you know, sometimes I'm not so sure, especially older women, they debate a lot. And I tell them, I already know your size, I can see it. You know, I look up to the thigh, just up to like right here, I'm like, I don't need to see your butt. I don't need to see all that. So I give them the size and just like, oh no, this ain't gonna fit me. Like they just look at it, no. I'm like, what you mean? All right, lift it up. I tell them, lift that shit up. And I'm like, I got played. I said, I'm sorry. Didn't see that over there. And then you gotta be careful with the Latinos and the African Americans, you know. They are biologically they got a bigger physique and beautiful women, by the way. I think they look great. But you know the butt is, you know, this butt's pretty big. We just gotta acknowledge it. It's pretty big. It's bigger than the average Caucasian, Asian, you know? So with those special women, I have to do the 360. I tell them, you know, I lift it up, turn, I spin them, you know, like spin them like a ball, like they do a little spin, and they love it when they do a spin. They're just like, okay, you know. I'm just like, if I keep it professional, because, you know, at the end of the day, I'm here to sell some pants, you know? I want to make sure you go home happy with the right size pants. And that the only reason you come back is not to return them or get a different size, because I don't want to go through that shit. I hate exchanging. I hate doing all that shit. I just want to get the deal done. You go home happy, I go home happy. I never see you again unless you're coming back to buy more pants. So please don't come back unless you're gonna buy more pants, or like, I don't know, offer us something, like, you know, like a free ticket to like the basketball game or something, you know? In my opinion, it's not to cover up the waist, it's to cover the bum. Huh, you think so, huh? The woman with lovely asses. There are a lot of women that cover up the stomach too. I said, we live in America. America's tough, you know? Like, I feel women. I feel every time. I never make a woman ever feel like ashamed or anything. I just said, oh, you know, I always tell them, I got your size. Don't worry. Listen, I see you walking by. I know you're like window shopping. You don't need to do that. You don't need to window shop with me. I could take care of you. Come here. I got your size, right? Not in a creepy way, like, miss, please just come in. Give me a minute, just come in. I see what you like, I see you eyeing that, I see you eyeing it, you want it, don't worry. Just tell me, pick a few, you like this one? Don't worry about it, just let me know when you're done choosing. And just, you know, just holler at me, I'll be right there in the corner, I'll let you decide on your own. Let you shop, let you talk about it, let you converse with your friends, converse with your husband, your boyfriend. You gotta FaceTime, go for it. Just don't get me in that shot. But at the end of the day, they always get me in the shot because they're like, this is what they do. Right. FaceTime, right? Boom, they're on the screen, they're talking. Oh, da 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 da. Oh, yeah, I'm here at the place. They got my size. Baby, tell me which one you like. Or, you know, like, oh, do you think this looks good? Da da da. Oh, can you check the size at home? Is it the same size here? And then to like, hey, take a look at this. Do you see it? And then they can't see it. So I gotta be like, show them here. Here you go. So I always end up in the shop. The one with all the asses. Any chance to show off? We love that shit. Yeah. It doesn't hurt. It doesn't hurt me. So. It's nice. It's definitely nice. I guess that's the perks of selling women's pants. For sure. And there's times where I have to. Like, I do everything I can to not touch a woman at work. I really do. Not, I mean, I don't. But there are times where to get the perfect measurement. You heard that? Did you just hear that? I have to like get close to women and I have to like touch them to get the perfect measurement. And this is the first line of the song. You gotta get really close. Like, if this is the booty, you gotta get the pants. You gotta make sure, you know, like the shit wraps around the waist. Comes with the territory, but you know, I'm luckily I haven't had to do that pretty often. Maybe like only like less than 10 times, which is great. That means my vision is working pretty good. I can like pinpoint accuracy, size you up with my eye. Okay. I think we got one more left. Seven minutes. Fuck. I hate leg day. Speaking about that whole thing, I start that job again this weekend. It's gonna really suck. Working 6 days a week really, really sucks. Really, really sucks. But, you know, I'm just glad it's not 7 days a week because I used to work 7 days a week. So that's why my January, Februarys are so special because I don't have to work weekends on those 2 months. So I'm planning on trying to like travel next year within those 2 months I have. Yeah. Hit up a few places. One of my coworkers went to LA today, so go for her. A little bit jealous, but I'm happy for her. She works hard. She's a vet, for sure. Where are you going? That sounds sarcastic. don't know. Maybe go to Canada. Maybe go to Ohio. I want to go everywhere. I'm going to try to hit everywhere. I really need to go try that barbecue in Ohio. I really want to go try this Ripley's Aquarium in Toronto. There's a lot of stuff out there. Fucking New York, man. It sucks. It really sucks. I went to K-Town, right? Like a week ago. I went to Koreatown in Manhattan. It sucks. It sucks. It's a block. It's always been like a block, but back then I think it was like two blocks. Now it's one block. It sucks, man. It sucks. There's nothing to do there. It's like five bakeries, five restaurants, maybe like one karaoke. You got a supermarket out of all places, and then the clubs are dead. I mean, if the clubs were alive, at least I'd be like, okay. But the clubs are gone too, so. Fuck that. Alright. Let's get done with leg day already. This looks like a movie set. Where is that? Looks pretty. Okay, step up bench. Alright, gotta step up bench. You know, if this, oh man, my eyes. If this ceiling right there wasn't here, I'd do this there. I mean here, but I gotta do this here. That's a beach at Lake Ontario. I'm getting dumber, man. I can't read anymore. It's a real struggle. It's beautiful. Big Mike. You and me, baby. Together. Sitting at the dock on the sunset. With some barbecue. Romantic for you, Mike, I agree. Where the fuck is everyone else today? Where is Angie? Huh? Where's Ange? Where's Ange? Where's Ladyboy? Where's Coffee King? We should all go here together. All of us. Oh shit. All of us. This picture looks so fake. Alright. Oh god, I hate these. Oh, we gotta do our side leg stuff. Our side leg stuff. Listen, I took that ish. Should look fake though. You're pretty good at Photoshop. Ew. Three, four, Damn, look at them legs. Yo, my legs are beefy, yo. I used to play soccer, man. It's the only thing that's like, stay beefy. But yeah, those, sorry, I'm out of breath, but the Photoshop skills are pretty good. Can you do that to my arms? I need to have some better arms, man. And my belly, oh my belly, you're gonna have a field day with my belly. You're gonna have to put a good 10 hours of just editing my belly. Gosh, next time I'll take a video. Can I say, you got good videoing skills then? You know, people that got good Photoshop skills usually translates to good editing skills. What can I say? We're at a point in life where I've got tons of plugins and Photoshop and stuff. It's real easy. The Striker HD. Hey, what up, Striker? I know who that is. I'm surprised you haven't followed, bro. What the fuck? You follow now? I'm upset at you, baby. Yo, Striker, you know what I just found out? I found out last week that everyone that has... Oh, you subbed? I was just about to... You know what? My bad, bro. My bad, yo. We're still friends, right? My bad, bro. I never doubted you. I always believed in you. You know that, right? You know I love you, right? Come on. We're good, right? We're good. Come on. Thank you, man. Thank you for the sub, man. Damn, look at me. I feel like an idiot now. I'm so sorry, dude. Next time you're free, let me know, alright? Let me know because I won't be, but just let me know anyway. How's everything? Dude, I hope you're doing good. Hope everything is good. I know you've been busy. We're just talking about how fake this picture is. If you want to judge it for yourself, let me know. A lot of Photoshop, you can see it. Oh fuck, I had night mode on too. You get a better view this way. What is on my phone? Why is my phone so dirty? Alright, for the record, this is my second phone. Alright? It's not my real phone. But you know what? I don't care, alright? My phone is dirty, so what? Okay. It's time to do the legs again. Fuck, we're running out of time. Love you too, man. Love you too, man. Come on. I don't gotta say that, man. You already know I love you, man. You don't gotta tell me that. Yo, I was just telling people before about the whole keto thing. How you're killing it, man. You know? think you lost like 60 pounds in like 3 months. So people could say it all day. Oh yeah, you know, I lost, or I know a person that lost X amount of weight in X amount of time. But dude, I saw with my own eyes. The keto diet, that shit works, yo. I seen this man lose 60 pounds in like 3 months. No joke. That shit is impressive. I wish I could say that, but Striker, I'm here. We lost a good solid 100%, 15 pounds within the 2 months we've been working out. We should be, we're supposed to be at 20 pounds lost in 5 more days at day 60. But you know what? We had a little setbacks. It's okay though. We'll get it. Day 65, we'll get our 20 pounds done. But overall, feels better. Feel healthy, feel a little bit smaller, but at the same time, a little bit bigger. But I'm happy. I'm happy with the progress we made. So, a lot of my inspirations came from my friend Striker here, so I got a lot to thank. This goes out to him. Got a lot of motivation from you, man. So, thank you. Thank you for everything, dude. I got to go, my battery about to die. You have a good night. Hey man, take care, Mike. I'll see you at the dock together, you and me. Last set, let's go. After, bro. I sent you pics of my chili. I'm making it tomorrow. Yo, you better send that shit. Or if not, post it up. Yo, my hips are killing me. I got into a car crash like almost 8 years ago. And ever since then, my hip was pretty like. It agitated, like, you know, randomly my hips were just sharp pains in my hip. It was good after a while, after it healed up. But I had a little unicycle incident where I fucked up my hip. And damn, yo, I thought my life was over. Because once you fracture your hip, you know, say goodbye to your life. Nothing's ever the same. But my hip was pretty good, but I don't know, today is like, it's weird now. I think it's from sitting down too much at work. I should stand more. Speaking about my work, my office is moving soon, within the next 2-3 months, to a big ass place. That shit looks beautiful. It's got like ceilings like 10 feet, 12 feet tall. We got giant windows that could see the streets. I might ask to get some like stand-up tables and stuff, stand-up desks. I sent you a message and added you. Oh shit. Okay. Alright, this one. This one's for Ange. Ange, if you're out there, hope you're doing good. You know, we miss you. It's one's for you. Man, we have stand-ups, all right. Damn it. I gotta stop crying about these workouts. Just do them. I did squats. The squats was the first thing we did. I can't do that shit again. Are you kidding me? How about you Photoshop me doing some squats? Huh? Huh? For the burn, do some more. I did 80 today. I'll be honest, I would do some squats, but I'm afraid my hip is gonna like snap off right now. Oh my god, that was 20? We did 20 before. 2, 3, 4. Okay. Alright. I'm gonna stand. I keep standing. Hey, tomorrow's Thursday. Alright, yeah, tomorrow's Thursday. I think it's gonna be. Oh, I think it's technically the last official end of the RL stream. We'll have more, but tomorrow will be the finale, I guess. If this was a TV show, tomorrow would be the finale. Technically, that was the last date I will be able to do an RL stream. Freely, without any sort of remorse, and just to do it, you know? No regrets. Well, honestly, I don't know what to do at this point. I feel like we've been everywhere, we've done everything. Can't find a place that's fun out here. So, go to karaoke. See, that's the issue. all the karaoke joints that we know of around here, they're all in the basement. Most of them are in the basement. There is like one that's probably not in the basement. And then, like, I can't sing, that's another thing. So, I have a goal that I set to do karaoke when I can like sing at least one song or something. So, oh, you don't even know, but I've been practicing singing for like the past 5 days now. Like 30 minutes before we start the stream, and I'll Google up some lessons, like how to sing, how to sound better, how to learn the pitch, how to keep your throat from closing up. All these little tips and tricks. Did they help? No, not yet. But I'm sure it will. If I do this every day for at least 30 minutes, I think it's better than nothing. Karaoke's not singing. It is. Bro, not gonna lie, I don't like no IRL streams. Miss your content, man. Oh, really? IRL streams are pretty whack, right? I don't like them either. I think the IRL streams are pretty whack. I think out of like the 10, not 10, how many IRL streams have we done? At least 15 IRL streams. I think like 20% of those was like, it's pretty fun. But the rest was just like, I don't know, if I'm not feeling it, if I'm not having fun, it's just, I don't know. Like, you guys can tell probably, like, oh, if I'm not feeling it, I'm just doing it. As soon as I feel like, oh, I'm just doing it just to do it, it's just like, okay, I'm just gonna end the stream. But then most of the time, I don't know when I'm just doing it just to do it. And then it's already like 3 hours over the limit of when I felt like I was supposed to end the stream. So, something I'm learning. Love the workout streams, but the queen and I love watching you just do stuff. You don't gotta go eat or go to bars. What about cooking or work? Interesting. This is a real test. I felt like I should not touch this wall anymore. We can prevent that by holding two eggs. This is gonna go bad. All right, we must not lose balance. Let's go. We could do 20, I think we can do 20. Okay, I'm goofy, right? The real test is doing all this with my left leg. One, two, three. 3, 4. Okay, keep it steady. 20. Okay. It's about to, Hydrate. Okay. This is the king. This is the queen. This is the hot. This is the wander. This is the big. This is the striker. This is everybody. Are those raw? No. They're hard boiled eggs. Oh. I have this stupid exercise when I stand on this damn thing right here. I have to hold this because I lose balance, right? You know, being a fat ass, you know, can't keep my balance. So, trying to like prevent myself from holding this so I can do it without holding anything. So I was like, fuck it, we'll use some eggs. And I can't drop the eggs. I'm not gonna drop the eggs. So, lesson learned. If you don't want to touch anything, you don't want to drop anything, eggs. Should work. But yeah, about the viral stream, you know, that's a good idea. I never thought, like, I should just do other things than work out in my house. In my tiny ass house. That's a good idea. Damn it. That really makes me think. What could I do? I can't play too much though. We'll think of something. Alright then. Tomorrow. Fuck the IRL stream tomorrow. Tomorrow we will IRL stream in my house. I think that will be a great IRL stream actually. I'll come straight home from work. I'll do my little bit of 30 minutes of karaoke practicing, singing practicing alone. We'll skip the workout tomorrow because tomorrow would have been an IRL day anyway. Wait, should I not do the IRL? Maybe I should do IRL stream? I don't know, I'm confused now. I'm confused. I was like, maybe we could just go come home and what the fuck am I gonna do at home? I don't know what to do. I'll think of something while I'm at work. I really don't want to go out anyway, man. IRL streaming, we try like everything out here. There's like no foods left to try. I'm so sick of drinking. Drinking just gets me depressed. You know? Can you do a cooking stream? Cooking stream? We could do a cooking stream. What the hell do I cook? Oh, fuck. Alright, maybe I should go food shopping. How about this? I got a plan for tomorrow. I got a great plan tomorrow. Actually, this is a great plan. Guys, I live a block away from a Korean supermarket. You know, a lot of Asian foods, a lot of Asian variety. Oh, here's a word I can't say. I learned yesterday to say it properly. Hereditary. Boom. We smart today. We can go food shopping. I can take you guys food shopping. It's literally one block away from my house. We can shop for the food that we're gonna cook. That's pretty awesome. That's a great idea. We shop, we come straight home. We should just cook right away. Oh, fuck. That's awesome. I like that. Oh shit, where am I going? I'm not done. We got one more last set to do. Hugs? Wait, we gave hugs? Oh, I'll give hugs, man. Haven't gave a hug in a bit. Hug it up. Every time I give a hug, it reminds me of how I gave a woman. Hope she's okay. She's not here today, but I hope she's alright. Ew, don't. I'm sweaty from working out. It's okay. I'm sweaty too. We're all sweaty. It's alright. Bring it in. Okay. Alright, so we did the eggs, right? Eggs are alright. Eggs are small. It's whatever. Eggs is light, you know, like when you start any type of game, right? You guys play games, right? You guys know what games are. You guys ever play like ranked games? You know, there's tiers to the shit, there's levels to the shit, right? You don't start out at gold or diamond or whatever game you play. You start from the bottom, you start with eggs. But once you surpass level egg, where do you go next? Right? That's the question. This is where you go. You go level pineapple, okay? This is the god level, right? One. You drop this shit, you're gonna be pissed. You got pineapple everywhere. So you can't drop these. And these are heavier too. Holy shit. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, we do 15. These are really heavy. One. Oh shit. Two. Three. Last one, 15. Okay. How do I drop these? boys. You witnessed. You witnessed God tier. I suggest you don't start with the pineapples. Work your way up to the pineapples. Start with the wall. Then get the eggs. Then you go to pineapple. Alright? God, I'm so hungry. No, we're working out. We can't be eating pineapple right now. You know better. We have a mission to hit. Okay. Oh. If you say it like that, you know. Come on, then I gotta cut up pineapples. Okay. Guys. I think we're done for today. I think we hit all our leg workouts. I don't think we have anything for the resistance bands yet. Yes, we hit our goals. We did it. Another leg day in the bag. I am very happy. Leg days are getting exciting because we are at eggs and pineapple level now. So maybe we can do more of those next week on the next leg day. I got a ton of exercises that I have to look up for legs. But at the moment, these leg workouts are totally fine. It's really working me out. Tomorrow I think we'll go out. I'll come home early. Well, not early, I'll come straight home. Again, 30 minutes of singing practice. We'll go right out to the supermarket and we'll go shop. Supermarket's a block away from my house. We'll go to an Asian supermarket. I'm very, very, very nervous to go in there with a camera. I kid you not, I'm so nervous, okay? The town I'm in, Asians are very well connected. There are like, guaranteed I'm gonna see somebody I know or someone that knows me or someone that thinks they know me or I might know them. I'm gonna run to somebody, I'm gonna feel a little bit different, you know, just I might get kicked out, I don't know. We'll see what happens. If we get kicked out, we get kicked out. Don't matter. We can still cook at home. I still think I got some stuff I can use at home. But to cook something delicious, I don't know, I'm not much of a cooker. Fuck it. Guys, thank you for joining me today. Wonder Woman, welcome back. Coffee King, Coffee Queen. Hello, guys. How are you guys doing? Hope you guys are doing good. Striker, thank you for the follow, dude. If you're still here, love you, man. I love you. And you know that I love you. So let that be that. And Big Mike, good night, bro. Charge that phone. Hot Gamer Woman, hope you're doing okay. Don't know what's going on, but we're gonna drink for you. We'll end the stream with a cheers, everyone. Everyone with your bottle of water. Cheers. Good night, guys. I'll see you tomorrow.